So students, this class is very important, very important, and in this class we are going to explain very important theory, that is your molecular orbital theory. Okay, so this is your molecular orbital theory, or this is also known as MOT, molecular orbital theory. So why this theory was implied? Particularly this theory was given by Horn and Mulliken. Two scientists have proposed this molecular orbital theory. So what are the drawbacks that was observed in VBT, valence bond theory? Okay, valence bond theory. So valence bond theory meaning means it is the overlapping of atomic orbitals. Overlapping of atomic orbitals. So what is the problem over here? So in VBT, whenever two atoms approaches to each other, when two atoms approaches to each other, then definitely the nuclei of one atom affect the electron clouds of other. Okay, so nucleus of one atom affect the electron cloud of other atom. And second case, that is it cannot explain magnetic properties of molecules like O2. Okay, it cannot explain, or it could not explain, it could not explain the magnetic properties exactly. Magnetic property of, I am directly writing O2 molecule. Magnetic property of O2 molecule. So these are few drawbacks that were found in VBT or valence bond theory. Okay. Then again, if you consider this bond order, in case of a VBT, bond order is always found as whole number. But in this molecular orbital theory, the tremendous thing is the bond order can also be fractional, that we will discuss in MOT. So these are the some major failure points that are observed in VBT. Okay, so let us discuss how this have been removed by or through your molecular orbital theory. So let us discuss about molecular orbital theory. MOT. That's clear. So particularly we discuss about diatomic molecules. Okay, diatomic molecules. Lots of similarities are there. So in case of VBT, we are considering the half-filled atomic orbitals. So here we consider the molecular orbitals. Okay, so here molecular orbital, first let us define what is a molecular orbital. So the molecular orbital, is a region region comprising two nuclei of respective atoms where the probability of electron density is maximum and a molecular orbital is formed by the linear combination of atomic orbitals. So linear combination of atomic orbitals LCAOS. Clear? Such linear combination are of two types. Okay, so I can write over here, a linear combination, may occurs in two ways. That is, one is called additive overlap. That is also called overlap through same phase and leading to bonding molecular orbital. Additive overlap always gives you bonding molecular orbital, which is stable and correspond to low energy. Bonding molecular orbital correspond to low energy. That means electrons are filled through bonding molecular orbital first. Okay, so filling of electrons also obeys your all these rules, Hund's rule, Pauli's exclusion principle, Abbas principle, all these rules. So now let us discuss few points. And another way, that is subtractive overlap or destructive overlap, you can say. Subtractive or destructive overlap. Subtractive or destructive overlap. That is overlap through opposite phase. You can write overlapping, okay? Overlapping through opposite phases. This leads to high energy, highly unstable orbital, that is anti-molecular orbital. It is unstable, and unstable means high energy. So from this it is concluded that if two atomic orbitals overlap with themselves in two ways in order to form molecular orbital, so if they add to each other in constructive manner, that means in same phase, then it will lead you bonding molecular orbital. If the addition is in destructive manner, then it will give you antibonding molecular orbital, which correspond to high energy, even then that of your isolated atomic orbital also. Is that clear? So highly unstable, that is antibonding molecular orbital. So it is concluded that number of atomic orbitals is equal to number of molecular orbital, because if I consider two atomic orbitals, then they combine in two ways to form one bonding molecular orbital and another one is antibonding molecular orbital. ओके वेरी गुड. सो नाउ सो यू सी हाउ लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स टेक्स प्लेस. ओके लिटिल बिट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन आई एम प्रोवाइडिंग यू. लीनियर कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स. लेट साई ए वन एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल, साई ए एंड साई बी आर टू एटॉमिक ऑर्बिटल्स. ओके सो इफ आई रिप्रेजेंट दिस वन एज अ फंक्शन ऑफ दिस वन इज योर साई ए, इज दैट क्लियर. अगेन दिस वन इज लेट से साई बी. If I consider their additive overlap, additive overlap means psi A plus psi B, then the final molecular orbital will be like this. That is the addition of a amplitude, same phase, addition with same phase. Is that clear? So this one will be psi A plus psi B. That means this one is bonding or antibonding molecular orbital? Yes, bonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital. Clear? Next, if I consider this one is let's say psi A, okay? And let's say this one. This one is psi B. If addition is subtractive, let's say subtractive addition is this. Look, so here psi A and psi B. Just imagine over here. Just I am adjusting over here. This one is let's say psi A, and this one is psi B. So again, the addition is subtractive addition. So this one gives you the antibonding molecular orbital. So what happen here? You see the amplitude little bit of less than that of psi A. So psi A minus psi B, that can be like this. Okay. So this one is psi A minus psi B, and it gives you antibonding molecular orbital. If having same amplitude, this one let's say psi A. So let's say psi B. Okay. So again, destructive overlap. You see, due to same height of crest electrode, so this can be nothing. Okay. So subtractive overlap is there. This one becomes psi A minus psi B. That clear? So constructive leading to bonding molecular orbital, destructive leading to antibonding molecular orbital. Let's say consider any homodiatomic molecule. Let's say I am considering about H2 molecule. Okay, so here this is half filled one atomic orbital. This one, let's say this one is psi A. For I am not considering hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen, for two hydrogen atom, one is psi A and another one is psi B, and two electrons. So 1s1 configuration, two electrons remain like this, antiparallel to each other. Okay, so they combine with each other in two manner, I have told you. So that is, one is, this is constructive manner, and another one is destructive manner. Destructive manner. Okay, so constructive manner, this is psi B. So this one I can say psi A plus psi B. This is bonding molecular orbital, and this one is psi A minus psi B. This is antibonding molecular orbital. Is that clear? So energy from here to here increases. Clear? So which one is more stable? Molecular orbital, bonding molecular orbital is more stable. Then your isolated atomic orbitals, and then your antibonding molecular orbital. So energy order, can you can write antibonding molecular orbital having higher energy than atomic orbitals, then bonding molecular orbital. Okay, again for linear combination, the atomic orbitals should have proper orientation. Improper orientation leading to no formation of any molecular orbital. That means atomic orbital should be properly oriented. That is, atomic orbitals should be properly oriented. Properly oriented means, you see, if this one, suppose this one is S orbital, so nucleus, this is positive phase, and the Z orbital, PZ I am considering, so this one P positive negative, this one is S orbital and this one is PZ orbital. Don't worry about sign, it represents only phase. So whenever they combine with each other, so what is happening there? Definitely, due to same orientation, the overlapping will be maximum. Okay, so if I consider this is one S orbital and two S orbital, I am considering, let's say, PX orbital. This one is PX, positive, negative. Okay, so do you think there will be effective overlapping? No, since due to improper orientation is there. So this improper orientation, nothing, no overlapping will be there, plus plus minus. Is that clear? Again, if you consider PX, this is PX and PY, this is PY. So do you think there will be effective overlapping? No. No effective overlapping. Why? Because of improper orientation. That is due to improper orientation. Okay. So now let us discuss how actually your bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals would like. Okay. How they are formed? By the linear combination of atomic orbitals in two ways. I have told you, one is subtractive way and another one is additive way. Okay. So if 2s orbitals I am considering here, positive phase plus 1s orbital is here having positive phase. Is that clear? So additive overlap. Additive overlap, or you can write over here constructive overlap, no problem. You can write constructive overlapping. So definitely there will be formation of molecular orbital like this. Okay, so here plus plus, this is the bonding molecular orbital. Bonding molecular orbital. So if I consider antibonding molecular orbital, then tell me, here this is positive phase, this is, let's say, negative phase. Okay, so positive negative phases are there, so this is subtractive overlap. Subtractive overlapping. So there will be a nodal plane over here. This is plus, this one is minus, and this is the antibonding molecular orbital. Antibonding molecular orbital. And an antibonding molecular orbital, here are atomic orbitals. Antibonding molecular orbital is highly unstable, having more energy, and it is represented by a star mark. So here, if this is 1s of hydrogen atom. This one is 1s of hydrogen atom. So this bonding molecular orbital is called sigma 1s. This is called sigma 1s. Sigma 1s. And this one is its sigma star 1s. That means antibonding. Pakistani hai, unstable hai. Okay. So all antibonding molecular orbitals are Pakistani, highly unstable. Next, let us see how. What about the p lobes? How p lobes interact to form molecular orbitals? Okay, so you know at the beginning that p orbitals always laterally overlapping occurs to give you corresponding bonding and antibonding molecular orbitals. Okay, so now let us discuss how in case of p orbitals. So you see, suppose this one is pz orbital. This orbital is pz orbital having one unpaired electron over here, or phase wise I am representing. This one is positive, this one is negative. That clear? Plus, let's say having same orientation, plus minus, this one also pz, this one is pz. Clear? So this two pz's additive overlapping is there. Additive overlapping is there. So it will give you like this. Effective overlapping is there. Pz, Pz. Okay. So plus, plus, minus, minus. Don't think these are the charges so that repulsion will be there. No, it simply represents the phase. Okay. So the situation is like this. Here will be electron density maximum here, and this is positive positive, negative negative. So this one is bonding molecular orbital, and since it is formed by lateral overlapping, so you can say this is pi to pz or any p orbital, let's say. Yes, if I considering 2p orbital, let's say I am considering, so this will be 2 pi to pz. Okay, so this one is 2pz orbital, 2pz orbital, I can say pi 2pz. Likewise, this is additive overlap leading to bonding, pi bonding. Okay, bonding molecular orbital. Next, if I just take this is positive negative, similar case pz, but this one having positive over here, negative over here. So tell me, this will be subtractive overlap. Subtractive overlapping is there. So subtractive overlapping means, so it will be something like this, positive negative, negative positive. So the situation is like this. No overlapping is there. This is a nodal plane. Okay, so this is positive negative, negative positive. See, two nodal planes are there. Okay, so this is, you can say pi star to p z, pi star to p z. Similarly, pi star to p x, pi to p y, and sigma bond also, sigma molecular orbital also formed. How? You see, if hadron overlapping is there, hadron overlapping is there. Again, I am considering this 2pz orbital. You see, hadron overlapping is there. This one is 2pz. Positive, negative. 2pz. And this axis is z axis. That clear? So another positive, negative. So overlapping is there. So I have told you, in overlapping, so that will be positive, positive. So finally, you will get something like this. Okay, so this one is sigma 2pz, sigma 2pz, positive, positive, bonding molecular orbital. Clear? Okay. Similarly, if I consider 2pz plus minus get added to here minus plus, that means overlap is subtractive overlap. Subtractive overlapping is there. So what will happen there? You see, molecular orbital will form like this here, like this, this. Okay, so this is plus minus minus plus. You see, there is a nodal plane. So you can say this one is sigma 2pz bonding molecular orbital, and you can here you can say sigma star 2pz, that is anti-bonding molecular orbital. That means number of atomic orbitals is equal to the number of molecular orbitals, because you know two types of they added to each other in two ways. One is additive nature or additive manner, and another one is subtractive manner. So you can write the number of atomic orbitals is equal to number of molecular orbitals, number of molecular orbitals. And again, a very important concept, you know, the filling of electrons in different molecular orbitals also follows. Okay, that means the filling of electrons, very important point, the filling of electrons in different molecular orbitals, in different molecular orbitals follows above's principle. Hund's rule and Pauli's exclusion principle. Pauli's exclusion principle. Regi, like that of atomic orbitals. Okay, so here you just remember two orders I am going to represent over here. Just remember, the first order is applicable up to 14 electrons, and above the 14 electrons you have to follow the second order. You just remember that order. Okay, little bit of a variation is there, but gradually you should remember these things. Okay, so up to 14 electron you just remember this order, sigma 1s less than sigma star 1s less than sigma 2s less than sigma star 2s, next less than pi 2px pi 2py degenerate, that means energy same. So these two are degenerate, so obeys Hund's rule. Okay, so pi 2px that is equal to pi 2pi, then sigma 2pz, next less than antibonding, that will be pi star 2px, that is equal to pi star 2py is less than sigma star 2pz. And remember, this order up to 14 electron species, that is up to dinitrogen N2, 7 plus 7 14 electrons, molecular orbital. So you have to consider its molecular configuration. Okay, so these orders. Next, another one order, that is sigma 1s less than sigma star 1s less than sigma 2s less than sigma star 2s less than sigma 2pz less than pi 2px, that is pi 2py less than pi star 2px, that is pi star 2py less than sigma star 2pz. So this is another order, it is above 14 electrons, above 14 electrons. So these two very important, these are known as molecular configuration, molecular configuration. Again, another point you remember, bond order that can be calculated. Bond order, that is half into NB minus NA. Okay, so NB means number of bonding electrons, number of bonding electrons. NA means number of antibonding electrons. Okay, so number of bonding electron means present in without star mark, without star mark orbitals. Antibonding means high energy, that is star mark wala. Okay, so star molecular orbitals. Okay, and the filling of electron obeys above's principle, Hund's rule, all these rule you know. Next, after bond order, magnetic character, presence of an unpaired electron, presence of an unpaired electron, okay, leads to paramagnetic nature. Presence of no unpaired electron, no unpaired electron, or you can say all orbitals are paired, that is diamagnetic in nature. Diamagnetic in nature. Okay, so let us proceed through several examples. Let us consider in case of hydrogen molecule. In case of hydrogen molecule. Okay, so hydrogen molecule total electron kete pila hai? Total number of electrons for hydrogen molecule 1 plus 1, that is 2. 2 electrons. 1 plus 1, that is 2. 2 electrons are there. So 2 electrons are arranged in different molecular orbitals. So 2 electron means the above order should be followed. So 2 electrons here. This is the small energy, this sigma 1 is having small energy. So 2 electrons will be here. That is at bonding molecular orbital. This is antibonding, this is bonding, this is antibonding, this is, these are bonding. And again, this is antibonding, antibonding. All the star marks are star wala orbital jitna hai, wo sab antibonding. Theek hai? So 2 electrons present at sigma 1 is. How you will represent it? You see, this one is one hydrogen atom, this one is hydrogen atom. So these are atomic orbitals. Atomic orbitals. Atomic orbital means 1s1, 1s1. Hydrogen molecule we are considering. So here, this is 1s1 and this one is 1s1. So one electron here, one electron here. Antiparallel to each other. Okay. So you see, this one is sigma 1s and 1s 1s combine in destructive manner to give you sigma star 1s. Okay, this is bonding, this is antibonding. So low energy orbital will be filled first by the electron. This electron, this electron come to here. Okay, so energy from here to here, energy is increased. Right now you tell me, in hydrogen molecule, calculate the bond order, that will be half into NB minus NA, number of bonding electrons in bonding 2, minus number of electrons in antibonding 0, so half into 2, that is 1. That's why we are writing H, single bond H, bond order 1. Is that clear? So it is whether paramagnetic or diamagnetic, you see, there is no unpaired electron in bonding as well as antibonding. All the electrons are paired in bonding. So this is diamagnetic. Diamagnetic in nature. Okay. So with this, let us discuss very important, that is, let's say, nitrogen molecule. Okay. If we consider nitrogen, so let us consider dinitrogen molecule. Okay. Let us consider N2 molecule, dinitrogen molecule. So how many electrons are there? 7 plus 7, that is total 14 electrons. 14 electrons to be distributed in different molecular orbital, it follows this order. Nitrogen having 14 electrons, so 14 electrons it obeys this order. So if I again write sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, you see sigma 2s, sigma star 2s, okay. Next, that is pi to px, pi to py, sigma to pz, pi star to px, pi star to py, sigma star to pz. So, in the order, so 14 electrons can be arranged as for the governed rule we have followed. So sigma 1s to low energy orbital 2, then sigma star 1s 2 2 2 8, and here you see these are degenerate orbitals 1 1 2 2. You can write like this, first 1 1 each, then pairing start. Okay, so how many electrons you just calculate? 2 2 4 2 6 2 8 10 12 13 14. That clear? All orbitals being filled up by the electrons. So molecular configuration is 2 2 2 14, up to this much. Okay, so if you represent it through molecular diagram, so this one will be one nitrogen atom, this one will be for one nitrogen atom. Okay, so just do it simply. This is 1s, one electron like this. Hydrogen, nitrogen having configuration beta 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1, 2pz1. Okay, so valence shell you should consider. So if you consider 1s, let's say 1s, then this is sigma 1s, sigma star 1s, 1s electron like this, and here 1s2, another nitrogen atom also 1s2, so these two electrons can be fill up like this, 1s2 1s2. So 4 electrons are distributed here, 1 2 3 4. Clear? Easy. Next, 2s, this is 2s 2s. Okay, so 2s having how many electrons again? 2 2, so 2, easy, 2 2 2 2. But here mention sigma 2s, this one is sigma star 2s. One is bonding, another one is antibonding. Two atomic orbitals corresponding two molecular orbitals. Okay, next, that is 2px 2py 2pz. So I am vanishing the above one, you just copy it first. Okay, then since there is no space, I am bound to omit all the things. So you see nitrogen I can write over here 2 2 2 2 2 2. Okay, okay. So 2px 2py 2pz, that can be like this. This one 2px 2py 2pz, and here this is 2px 2py 2pz. Okay, so 3 electrons, 1 2 3, and here these 3 electrons can also represented like antiparallelly, no problem, antiparallelly. So here like this, like this, like this. Okay, so 2px 2px, tell me what type of bond they would form. Next, that is 2px with 2px, that will be pi 2px. Is that clear? Next, 2py, beta, equal energy, this is pi 2px, this is pi 2py. Then, they are corresponding antibonding molecular orbitals also form. Pi star 2px, pi star 2py. Okay. Next, 2pz and 2pz. Definitely the orbital will be sigma 2pz. That is lies above. And the final one, that is 2pz and 2pz, that will give you sigma star 2pz. This is the order up to 14 electron system. Okay. So now just arrange electrons like this. 2px, 2px, pi 2px, 2 electrons. Lower energy orbital, getting first. 2py, 2py, 2 electrons, get ready. So 4 electrons already have gone. So 2pz, 2pz, 2 electrons are there. And since these are antibonding molecular orbital, high energy and no electrons are there now to fill up. So this is the molecular orbital energy diagram for N2 molecule. Okay. So if you calculate bond order, so that will be half into NB minus NA. Number of bonding electrons, bina 2p, bina cap wala, all Indians, not Pakistanis, 2, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 8, 2, 10. So number of bonding electron la 10 minus number of antibonding electron, you just calculate 2, 2, 4, only 4. Okay, so half into, so that will be 6. So the bond order is 3. So there exist 3 bonds over nitrogen atom, nitrogen molecule. Okay. So next, what about ZC? Magnetic character. Magnetic character. So do you have any unpaired electron at the middle in this molecular orbital? No. All the orbitals are paired. So this is diamagnetic. N2 is diamagnetic. Means not attracted by magnet or weakly attracted by magnet. Not attracted by magnet. Okay. So next class we'll discuss about some ions, oxide, peroxide, superoxide, okay, azide, their molecular configuration and also molecular orbital diagram with their magnetic character and all these properties we will discuss in next class. Okay, thank you.